Developers using Bluetooth Low Energy have a tough time today. The stability is inconsistent and it burns through the battery, which ultimately leads to your users unhappy with your app. The good news is that in Android L, we're fixing this. My name is Megan. I'm a product manager on the Android team, and I'm here to tell you about two key improvements, peripheral mode and improved scanning. Bluetooth Low Energy is a low-power form of Bluetooth communications. It allows devices like your Android phones and tablets to communicate with peripherals like fitness bands or Bluetooth beacons. Your Android phone in central mode can scan for advertisement broadcasts from peripherals, and it can also form connections to exchange additional data. Bluetooth Low Energy scans first landed in Android 4.3, and one of the biggest drawbacks was that scanning prevents a device from going into standby. If your app needs to scan frequently or constantly, say for nearby Bluetooth beacons, preventing your users' devices from going into standby will kill their battery. And trust me, no one likes an app that drains their battery. In order to address this problem, we have offloaded scanning to the background in a way that allows the device to enter into standby when it isn't detecting advertisements from nearby devices. But at any given part of your user's day, their device may be bombarded with advertisement packets from a myriad of devices in their vicinity. This would still prevent their device from entering standby. To address that, we've added new APIs that make your scanning even more efficient. These APIs allow you to specify filters to reduce the number of potential advertisement packets your application needs to process. You can set filters on specific parts of the packet, like service UID, service data, and manufacturer data. With these filters in place, your user's device will only wake up from standby and tell your app when it finds a packet matching your filters. You only get notified when Android finds a nearby device you're really interested in. Your user's device will keep scanning in the background indefinitely until you stop the scan manually. But your user's device may also be connected to other devices, like a Bluetooth headset. Starting in the L release, Android will optimize and balance scanning with other activities and power based on your requests. You can request to have Android scan with low latency. This will increase how quickly you detect the device you're interested in when it comes within range. But even background scanning consumes power, and scanning more frequently will consume more power. If detecting the other device is not time critical, like when the phone is in standby in the user's pocket, you can ask Android to scan less frequently and save power. We've added peripheral mode too. An Android device can now act as a Bluetooth Low Energy peripheral. It can broadcast advertisement packets and form data connections with other BLE devices. In fact, your apps can specify the contents of the broadcast packet, like service UID, service data, and manufacturer data. This allows your app to produce more meaningful advertisement packets for your use case. But the space in an advertisement packet is limited. If another app has already filled it up, then there is no space for your app's packet contents. To fix this problem, Android now allows multiple apps to advertise concurrently, allowing each app its own packet. If your app needs to advertise more frequently to enable other devices to detect it quicker, you can request low latency. Of course, advertising more frequently will consume more power. If your use case allows advertising less frequently, you can request low power. Just like with scanning, Android will optimize how often to transmit your advertisement packets, balancing power and other demands on Bluetooth, such as scanning or a Bluetooth audio connection. Now, try out our improved scanning and peripheral mode support for yourself. Thanks for watching.